in search of time P. P like present time, stories that happened to me. P like past, stories told by my mother, to which I hang my present stories. You know, I'm trying to make a link between the present and the past. And I should ask time with a L, like lost time, in search of lost time, the great novel by Marcel Proust, to which I try to link all my life, my mother life, the history of France, anything past and present. So today is Monday, July 24th, 2017, and I'm in Paris. And this weekend, I went for a nice dinner at friends that I had seen a lot when I was living in America. They are French, and they have moved back to Paris. And live, I just learned recently, in a street called Rue de la Ferronnerie. Immediately, that name reminded me of the story of Henri IV, Henri IV, who was a beloved king of France, and who was assassinated in that street, Rue de la Ferronnerie, by Ravaillac in 1610. So as I was going there, I was remembering a story that my mother used to tell us, because she liked that king very much. In fact, she was like a lot of people of her generation and of mine too, because this king was very popular for several reasons. But one was that he was wishing to all French families at the time to have every Sunday a chicken in their pot. So it was called the poule au pot, and it was a symbol of his economics and his desire of prosperity for the country. That was the first popular and well-known thing. The second one was that he was a very tolerant, religiously speaking, man. He was raised a Protestant, and after the war of religion in France at the end of the 16th century, it was his turn to become king. But to be king of France, you had to be a Catholic. And as he said, to become king, he converted to Catholicism and said a very famous word, which is, Paris is well worth a mass. So that's what Henri IV was. And he was a bon vivant. He loved life. He had, for instance, my mother used to tell anecdotes like the one describing his hygiene to try to get rid of microbes and fleas and all kind of insects, vermin. He, according to my mother, he used to wear a necklace with hanging at the necklace a herring. It's a dry herring. Seems like something special, but I'm especially fond of herrings because in my youth, my mother used to make a lot of them in oil, herrings in oil, and I love that, and I would love to promote that very good food. So beside that, he had the reputation of being a great lover. At least he had many mistresses. And one of the stories always told by my mother, who had so many to tell us, was that one day Henri IV was visiting one of these mistresses by surprise. When he arrived, the woman was in her bed, and she was with another lover. So as soon as she heard that the king was coming, she asked the lover, the resident one, just to leave. He had no time to hide, but under our big bed. So Henri the Fourth arrived, made love and all what he wanted with the lady. And at the end, he was very hungry and asked for some food, like jams and honey and bread. And he started to eat in the bed and took a jar of honey and took it in his hand and just put that under the bed without even looking at who was there and saying, everybody needs to live, I mean, to have food to live. So you imagine he was a very jolly guy, and I like that very much. So I also tried, because the purpose of this little chronicle is to demonstrate the continuity between my life, my memories, my mother's, and obviously being a Christian, linking it to some part of the novel of Proust, In Search of Lost Time. And the one I'll describe is a very, I'll read it, it's a very short one. It's about Henri the Fourth and a mistress. It takes place in the fugitive at the end, when the narrator is in a train coming back from Venice with his mother, and they are speaking of things that you speak of in families, you know, who got married, what happened here and there. And he speaks also about all the marriages in the Guermont family. So what does he say? His mother said that about her own mother, his grandmother. You remember too, it shocked your grandmother that for centuries, past daughters of the house of Grammont, who have been perfect saints, have borne the name Corisande in memory of Henri the Fourth's liaison with one of their ancestors. These are things that may happen also, perhaps, among the middle classes, but we conceal them better. So that's one a little anecdote about Proust, my mother, Henri IV, and I.